Do you remember these motorcycles? The Mission RS and the Lightning LS218? These electric superbikes made quite a stir when they were first introduced. The motorcycles appeared on most of the major motorcycling magazines and unusually on some tech publications too. Fast forward to 2018, the Mission motorcycles is pretty much dead. And about the Lightning, honestly, I have no idea about the current whereabouts of the motorcycle or the company. Now, there's a new kid on the block, the Saroléa MANX7, a Belgian electric superbike. The chances are you might never heard of the company Saroléa, me neither. The Saroléa is a Belgian company founded in 1850 for building firearms. 42 years later, in 1892, they started to build bicycles under the name Royal Saroléa. In 1901, Saroléa built their first motorcycle by just slapping on a 247cc single-cylinder engine into one of their bicycles. Since then, they continued to build motorcycles and did a little bit of racing until the company disappeared in the 60s. But in the year 2010, the Saroléa was resurrected by twin brothers Torsten and Bjorn Robbins with the sole purpose of building high-performance electric race machines. In 2014, they built their first race bike, the SP7, designed and engineered completely in-house. The SP7 competed in the Isle of Man TT0 and took an impressive 4th place with an average speed of 150 km per hour. In the following years, they continued to race in the Isle of Man TT0 and achieved consistent performance. The MANX7 is the road-going version of their Isle of Man TT racer, the SP7. The design of the MANX7 really emphasizes on Saroléa's vision, modern aesthetics capitalizing on traditional values. Unlike any other existing superbike, the MANX7 looks quite different. It has a certain classic vibe to it. There are no complicated lines or shapes. Everything is quite simple and minimalistic. It's this beauty of simplicity that gives the MANX7 a unique identity. But don't let that classic look deceive you, because under the skin, the MANX7 is a proper beast. The motorcycle is held together by a handmade carbon fiber monocoque chassis, the kind of stuff that you find in exotic superbikes like Trollen and Superleggera, BMW, HP4 Race Carbon, etc. The swing arm is also completely made of carbon fiber and is made by their partner Solway. Every single nut and bolt in this motorcycle is made of titanium. The new Gas R Series wheels are made of lightest aluminum alloy available and is made by OZ Racing. You can also find these wheels in some of the WSB racing machines. The MANX7 also gets top-of-the-line suspension hardware straight from its racing sibling. The motorcycle is equipped with a set of Ohlins FGRT forks at the front and a TTX shock at the rear. With the use of top-of-the-line lightweight components and exotic materials for construction, the MANX7 only weighs at just 217 kg, which is pretty reasonable for an electric superbike, especially when you consider the Zero SR weighs 208 kg. The MANX7 is powered by an air-cooled brushless DC motor, which puts out a software-limited 160 brake horsepower and a monstrous 450 Nm of torque. As a result, the MANX7 can do 0 to 100 km per hour in just 2.8 seconds and will reach a software-limited top speed of 250 km per hour. The electricity is supplied by a lithium-ion 400-volt battery system, which comes in three capacities: a 14kWh battery, which provides 230km range, an 18kWh battery, which provides 280km range, and finally, a massive 22kWh battery with 330km range. Combining that with the quick charging capability, which allows the motorcycle to charge from 0 to 85% in just 25 minutes, makes the MANX7 quite practical for day-to-day use. The Saroléa is only planning to build 20 motorcycles this year. As I said earlier, the MANX7 has three variants, and all of them are pretty expensive. The base 14kWh variant costs $48,000. The 18kWh variant retails at $52,000. And finally, the top-of-the-line 22kWh variant retails for $55,000. So what do you think about this MANX7? Leave your thoughts in the comment section down below. And as always, if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Or if you loved it, please consider subscribing to the channel. See you guys next time. Ride safe.